Learn about an easy approach to dependency injection for SwiftUI. It's highly inspired by the environment and was first presented by Antoine and Vincent Pradeilles. This video does not have a sponsor. If you like my work or learn something from my videos, please consider subscribing. And if you're an indie developer working on your own projects, I suggest checking out Launch Party on the Mac App Store. It's a free project management tool that I developed myself. So for this video, I have already prepared a basic example project and we will quickly go over it and then we will add a package to do the dependency injection. So what I have right now is just a SwiftUI view up here. It's just called content view. It's very similar to the one that's auto-generated, but it also has a view model here, which is defined down here in the same file. Now, usually you wouldn't define multiple types in one file. I'm just doing it for the sake of this video. The content view model is just an observable object that's added as a state object to our content view. And then it has one published property called title, which is shown in the text in our content view here. Once the content view appears, it calls the viewModel.setupTitle function. So just a very simple like initializing loading data function that is available right here in our view model. Currently, it just says title equals ABC, and that's also reflected in our preview here on the right. But we want to change that to use our title service. So if you scroll down a bit, you will see that we have a title service protocol, which just has one requirement, and that is a getTitle function that just returns a string. I have already as well created a class that conforms to the title service. It's called myTitleServiceImplementation. It of course implements the getTitle function and just returns the string myTitle. What we now want to do is use this myTitleServiceImplementation in our content view model without having to make the content view model know about which title service they actually use. So for example, when writing a unit test for this setup title function here, you might want to inject a different implementation of the title service, like a mocked implementation. And in the running app, you actually want to use an implementation that fetches this title from some sort of server, from some sort of API, or does any computation with it. That's basically the motivation for dependency injection. So right now we're not using the title service whatsoever. We're just assigning ABC in our setup title function in the content view model. So now let's have a look at a package. And I've posted about this on Twitter a few days ago. The package is called Dependency. And once again, it's highly inspired by an article and a video from both Antoine Vandale and Vincent Pradeilles. Now, you might have seen these videos or that video, but it's been over a year, I think, since it was published. So I figured now is the right time to let me talk about it as well. The idea is to have a very SwiftUI environment style access to your dependencies. And here in this line, you can see how all of that works. So you just have a property wrapper called addDependency. You can use the keyPath syntax to access a specific service. And then you can just use that service in your views or your view models directly without the view model knowing which implementation of the service it uses. There is a tiny bit of setup required, and that's this box up here, but we'll go through it and I'll explain to you how everything works in more detail. So first of all, let's scroll up here, click on code and copy the GitHub URL. Then we can go back to Xcode, click on file, add packages. I always like to let it load for a second here, and then I just paste in the URL into the search bar. Now, Swift Package Manager and Xcode often is unable to load the README. I don't know what the issue is here, but nevertheless, we can just click Add Package. Click Add Package again, just make sure that it's added to the correct target. Now, in this case, there is just one target, as this is just an example app. And now it is available here in our package dependencies. So as I said, the first step is to register our service as a dependency for this package. So for that, let me scroll down here to the bottom of the file and I'll create another comment saying register service as dependency. There are two steps. First of all, we need to create a dependency key. This is similar to an environment key in SwiftUI. And then we need to create an extension on dependency values, exactly the same as the environment values. So let's create a private struct. And our service is called title service, so I will call this one title service key, and it conforms to dependency key. In order for that to work, we of course need to import the package first, just like that. Okay, now this dependency key only has a current value, which is a static variable. Its type is the protocol that we want to register. So in our case, the protocol is called title service. And here we can set the default value. So in our case, we want to use the my title service implementation. This is the default that will just be used throughout your entire app if you don't choose to inject another version of that dependency or another implementation of the title service in this case. So that's already it with the dependency key. Next, let's create an extension on dependency values. And here we just add a new variable. We can give it any name that we want. This is basically the key path that will be used with the property wrapper. This, of course, is a title service. And then we just write our own custom getter and setter. So to get the title service, we will access capital self, so the type and not the instance of the type, with our key. So we call the key title service key. And we need the dot self here to get the type of the key. That's already the getter. And now the setter is very similar. We just assign a new value to this key, just like that. New value is an argument that we get passed in any setter closure, just so you know, you don't have to explicitly capture it. Okay, so that's all of the registering already done. Next, we can actually start using this service. So let's jump back into our content view model here. And in there, we can just access our dependency using the @dependency property wrapper. Now we can use the key path syntax, and you will see that we now already have autocomplete for our title service. And let's give the variable a name as well. We don't even need to specify the type, as that's inferred through this variable right here. So we know that it is a type conforming to the title service protocol. And now in our setup title function, we can just say title service dot get title, which is the one required function that any title service needs to implement. Since the property wrapper now can look up the title service, and we specified it to be my title service implementation as a default, this function right here will be called when we say title service dot get title. And as you can see in the SwiftUI preview on the right, this already works. So in the beginning, the title would be an empty string, but after calling setup title and all of this getting resolved backwards, basically, this function here will be called and our title will be the string containing the words my title. Now, one more thing I quickly want to show to you is how you can manually, let's say, override or inject another dependency. So we could create a second class here conforming to the title service. So I would just call this mock title service. And this conforms to title service, of course. So we need to implement the get title function. And I will just say return mock title. Now this will never get called because currently we don't use this anywhere, as we're just using the my title service implementation as a default. But if we wanted to, we could, for example, go to the initializer of the content view model and now override which title service we want to use. You could also do that on an app level. So we could go to dependency example app, and in the initializer of the app here, we could just say, first of all, of course, we need to import dependency. And then we could just say dependency values using our nice key path of title service right here. And we could say we want to use the mock title service for the entire app. Now, I think in the preview, nothing will... Oh, actually, okay, that's interesting. I didn't know that the preview actually uses the abstract, but apparently it does. So we've set the mock title service to be injected as our title service in our app. And now that will be used throughout the entire app, and our view model has no idea about which implementation of the title service it uses, but it can always access the one that is currently injected. Now, of course, this is mostly important for testability and also to just reduce visual clutter so you don't have to pass around these services everywhere. That's it for this video. If you learned something, please make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel for future videos. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.